Yeah, good morning students. So yesterday we have done some problems related to multi-stage compressor. Today some more problems we are going to do. Good morning. Okay, so today some more problems we are going to do. So it is question number, it is 2019 question paper. In 2019, one problem they have asked for multi-stage compressor. Question number 7B. So what is question number 7A? This derivation already we have done. Derive the expression for water when compression is isentropic for a single stage reciprocating air compressor. This derivation they have asked. Which derivation you have to do? In this here, you have to do this derivation. I am talking about this question number 7A. So work done you have to calculate. So work done formula is equal to N divided by N minus 1 MR T1 P2 by T1 whole to the power N minus 1 by N minus 1. So like this one derivation we have done in 2-3 class back. So this derivation you have to do for question number 7A. Since it is isentropic process, so in place of N, just we have to mention gamma. Okay. If in the question paper they will ask polytropic process, then you should write N. If they will ask isentropic process, then just in place of N, you just write gamma. Remaining all the derivation, everything will remain same. Okay. Only you replace N with gamma. This note also I have kept in the group. So this part already we have completed. So today we will discuss this question number 7B. Okay. So you keep in mind all the previous year question paper we are solving here in the class, starting from unit 1. Okay. So by the time we will complete our syllabus here, by the time we will complete all the 5 units, we have completed all the previous 5-year question paper also. 2016, 17, 18, 19 and 20. All the 5 years question paper also simultaneously we are solving in the class. Okay, so that's why whatever the problems I am solving, you just prepare it at the home. So today we are going to discuss regarding this question number 7B. Okay, so this question we are going to discuss today. So this is a two-stage, a single-acting two-stage reciprocating air compressor. You can see this one. It is a single-acting two-stage reciprocating air compressor. Means it comes under multi-stage air compressor. So yesterday already we have done one problem related to two-stage air compressor. Okay. So today we will do one more problem, this one. So that all of the doubt will clear. Because here some volumetric efficiency also we have to calculate. This clearance ratio is given. So how to do this problem, I will tell you. But before that, let me copy this question. We will copy this question and we will paste here and we will solve. This is the question that we are going to solve now. Okay, so the question is, a single acting two-stage reciprocating air compressor compresses 4.5 kg per minute of air. So before starting the first thing is we will write down the given data. First, we will write down the given data. Given a single acting two-stage reciprocating air compressor. Okay, so since it is two-stage reciprocating air compressor, so it's better after we will draw the PV diagram. Because from PV diagram only we are going to write the formula. PV diagram we will plot. This is pressure axis. This is volume axis. Since it is two stage, so this is the first stage we will draw here. 0.0 to 0.1, this is the suction process. Then 0.1 to 0.2. This is the compression. Then 0.2 to 0.3, this is the intercooling. And again, again from 0.3 to 0.4. It is compressor in second stage compressor, and then from 0.4 to 0.5 in the exhaustion. Okay. So this is the first stage of compression. This is the second stage of compressor. So here this is the lowest pressure. That is suppose P1. Here in the intermediate stage, suppose the pressure is P2. And here in the upper stage or second stage, suppose that the highest pressure is P4. So like that you will indicate, so that it will be easy for you to write down the formulas. So since it is two stage, so we have drawn the two stage compressor. This is the first stage. This one is first stage. This one is second stage. So now next what we will do, we will write down the given data. So given data, what is given? A single acting two-stage reciprocating air compressor compresses 4.5 kg of air per minute. So it compresses 4.5 kg of air per minute, means it is mass flow rate of air given. Kg is the unit of mass, and per minute is it is mass flow rate. So mass flow rate of air is how much? 4.5 kg per minute. So it is 4.5 kg per minute. And already I told you, in entire TE1, we have to convert this mass flow rate in kg per second. 1 minute is how much second? 1 minute is 60 seconds. So how much we will get it? We will get 4.5 divided by 60 kg per second, and if we will calculate it, the answer you will get is 0.075. If you will solve this, it will get 0.075 kg per second. So mass flow rate, like this, in systematical way you should solve this question. Okay, because in exam it will be a 15 marks, 10 marks to 15 marks question, like that they will ask. Okay, so you draw the PV diagram, then systematically you write down the given data, then point by point you find out the requirement of the question. So there you will get the full marks. Next, from 1.013 bar and 150 degree Celsius, I think it is 15 degree Celsius, let me check it, because incoming air temperature cannot be 150 degree Celsius. So let me check it, how much it is. Okay, it is 15 degree Celsius. Huh? So we will change here. So degree symbol. Where is the degree symbol? So this 15 degrees Celsius. So it's 9 to the power 1. So then what is given? The inlet pressure is 1.013 bar. Okay. And inlet temperature of air is 15 degrees Celsius. So we will note it down here. So inlet pressure is given P1 equal to how much? 1.013 bar. Means this pressure was given. Okay. Inlet pressure equal to 1.013 bar. Now we have to convert this into kilopascal because the power, whatever the power we have to calculate here. The unit of power is kilowatt. Okay, so that's why we have to convert everything into kilo. So one bar is how many kilopascal? One bar is 100 kilopascal. So we have to multiply 100 over here. So that you will get 101.3 kilopascal. Okay, so this is the power we have got. Now the next thing is we have to calculate the temperature. So what is the inlet temperature? Inlet temperature is 10 degrees Celsius. This is the inlet temperature of the compressor. This is the compression process and 0.1 is the inlet temperature of the compressor. So inlet temperature is 15 degrees Celsius. T1 equal to 15 degrees Celsius. So we have to add here 273 so that we will get it like 288 Kelvin. Through a pressure ratio of 9. Pressure ratio is how much given? 9. Okay. So what do you mean by pressure ratio? Can anybody tell? What is the meaning of this pressure ratio? It is given pressure ratio is 9. So what is this 9? Is it P1? Is it P2? Or is it P2 by P1? Or is it what? What is this 9 value? Only one member is only replying. Okay, 313, 305, P2 by P1. Okay, see here how many pressure ratios are there? 344, yes, P2 by P1. Okay, so it here, this is called the first stage, this is called the second stage. First stage is also called the lower stage, second stage is also called as higher stage. Here the stage value they didn't mention, they only mentioned pressure ratio is 9. So for the first stage, what is the pressure ratio? P2 by P1. For second stage, what is the pressure ratio? P4 by P2. But which stage pressure ratio they have not mentioned? Okay. If only pressure ratio they will mention like this, then here we can write for the first stage, the pressure ratio is P2 by P1. So you will write here P2 by P1 equal to 9. And also, for the second stage, what is the pressure ratio? P4 by P2. So P4 by P2, we can also write it as 9. Okay, so try to understand. If in the question paper here they will write, for first stage, the pressure ratio is 9. Then we should write for the first stage, it is P2 by P1 equal to 9. If in the question they will mention, for second stage, pressure ratio is 9. Then which is second stage? This is second stage. For second stage, what is the pressure ratio? We should only write P4 by P2 equal to 9. But the stage value they have not mentioned. So overall, they are telling the pressure ratio is 9. Means for both the stage, the pressure ratio is 9. Okay. So for the first stage, what is the pressure ratio? P2 by P1. So P2 by P1 is 9. For second stage, what is the pressure ratio? P4 by P2. So P4 by P2 is also equal to 9. Right? Next, the intercooling is perfect. Okay. So obviously, what do you mean by perfect intercooling? Yesterday I told you, if the intercooling is perfect, then pressure ratio should be same. Okay. So P2 by P1 is equal to P4 by if the pressure ratio is same. And also the inlet temperature for the first stage compression process should be equal to the inlet temperature of the second stage compression process. For the first stage, yes, T1 equal to T3. For the first stage, which one is the inlet temperature during the compression process? T1. For second stage, during which one is the inlet temperature for the compression process? That is T3. Okay, so T1 equal to T3 if it is a perfect intercooler, right? So what will be the value of T3? So T1 is equal to E3 equal to T1 is how much? T1 is 288. So T3 will also will get us 288 Kelvin. All right. Next. And the law of compression and expansion is PV to the power 1.3 equal to constant. This is to the power. Okay. PV to the power 1.3 equal to constant. So 1.3 is nothing but the value of N. Value of N is given 1.3. Assuming this is the new thing. Okay. This part is the new part. Assuming the clearance volume of both the stages is 5% of their swept volume. Okay. So what it is telling? For both the stage, for stage one as well as for stage two, the clearance volume is 5% of swept volume. Okay. So clearance volume means VC is equal to 5% of swept volume. Swept volume means VS. That implies VC equal to 5% means 5 divided by 100 of VS. That implies this VS you take to this side. So what it will become? It will become VC by VS equal to 5 by 100 means or 0.0. 5 by 100 is called 0.05. Yes, it is small c. This VC by VS is called as clearance ratio. Already I have explained this. VC by VS means the ratio between clearance volume and swept volume is called as clearance ratio, that is small c. The small c value equal to 0.05. The small c is called clearance ratio. What is this small c? This is required to calculate the volumetric efficiency. See, what is the formula of volumetric efficiency? Formula of volumetric efficiency is actual volume divided by swept volume, and also it is same as 1 plus c minus c whole into E2 by P1 whole to the power 1 by N. This c is nothing but clearance ratio. Okay, so in this question, this C value was given. This is the previous last day, last class we have done this problem. Last to last class. So this C value was given 0.05. And what is given? Speed of the compressor is given 300 rpm. So speed means capital N value is given 300 rpm. Okay, now what we have to calculate over here? We have to calculate here, we have to calculate indicated power. In the first point, we have to calculate indicated power. Second point, and cylinder swept volume, we have to calculate. Swept volume means VS, we have to calculate. These two things we have to calculate. This is the end of this problem. Okay. First is indicated power, which is nothing but the work done by the compressor. And second thing is swept volume. These two things we have to calculate for this problem. Okay. So one by one, we will start it. You be prepared with calculator. So first point is we are going to calculate the indicated power. So first we are going to calculate indicated power. indicated power. This is the first time. So how to calculate the indicated power? Okay. So indicated power, it is nothing but IP. So power is nothing but work done here. So indicated power is nothing but work done by two stage compressor. Okay. So what is the formula of work done by a two stage compressor? Since it is two stage compressor, so you have to multiply two into the same formula, n by n minus 1, mr t1 whole into p2 by p1 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1. Yes or no? Because yesterday only I have told you the formula will remain same. If it is a single stage, multiply 1. If it is a two stage, multiply 2. If it is a three stage, multiply 3. Clear? But this formula will be applicable if it is for perfect intercooling. If it is perfect intercooling. If in the question paper they will mention that perfect intercooling, like here they have mentioned intercooling is perfect, then only you can apply this formula. Okay. If the intercooling is not perfect, then separately, individually, we have to apply this work done formula for both the stage of compression. Okay. So for imperfect intercooling, one problem I will do in next class and we will complete this one. Okay. So for this problem, it is, since it is perfect intercooling, so we have written the formula. Now simply we will put the value, n is 1.3 divided by 1.3 minus 1. What is mass flow rate? Mass flow rate is 0.075 into capital R. So R is universal gas constant. Its value is 0.287 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. This value you have to remember. They will not mention. R value is 0.287. And you should take in kilojoules. So that the unit of work done or power you will get in kilowatt. Okay. So R value we will put 0.287 into, what is T1? T1 is 288. Okay, 344, already you got answer. Let me complete it. I am little bit late. Let me go there. So T1 is 288 into P2 by P1. What is P2 by P1? P2 by P1 pressure ratio is 9. Okay, so P2 by P1 value is given 9. So P2 by P1 we will write directly 9 whole to the power n is 1.3. So 1.3 minus 1 whole divided by 1.3 minus 1. Now if we will solve this one, how much we are getting? We have already got some answers. 344, 305, 35.48 kilowatt. Okay. So if when we will solve it, we will get 35.48. So this is the indicated power or work done by the compressor. Yeah, very simple. So the first part we have completed. Now the we will do the second part. What we have to calculate in the second part? In second part, we have to calculate the cylinder swept volume. Swept volume of the cylinder we have to calculate. So in second part, we have to calculate, you think how to calculate swept volume of the cylinder. You tell me how to calculate swept volume of the cylinder. Because already similar type of problem we have done. Second part, we have to calculate cylinder swept volume. VS. Okay. So how to calculate this swept volume? So there are either directly by applying the formula you can calculate. I mean, what is the formula we have to apply here? Left volume equal to pi by 4 p square l into n by 60. Okay. But here in this question, speed is given, but diameter of the cylinder is not given. Length of the cylinder is not given. If you see the given data, diameter and length of the cylinder is not given. So this formula we cannot use. Okay. Now, what other formulas are there? One volumetric efficiency formula is there. Volumetric efficiency equal to actual volume by swept volume, which is equal to 1 plus C minus C P2 by P1 whole to the power 1 by N. Here only you have to remember the formula. Okay, so the last week we have done one problem. Here I have told you the volumetric efficiency. So volumetric efficiency equal to VA, that is the actual volume of air enter, divided by swept volume, which is equal to 1 plus C minus C whole into P2 by P1 to the power 1 by N. So this formula we are going to use over here. Yes, 305, volumetric efficiency. Okay, so here, what is given? First, we have to calculate, in order to calculate this swept volume, first we have to calculate volumetric efficiency. Once we can calculate this volumetric efficiency, then very easily by applying this formula, we can calculate the swept volume. Now, our aim is first we will calculate volumetric efficiency, then we will calculate the volume of air entered. Okay, then applying this formula, we can calculate the stroke volume. So like this, you have to analyze how to solve the problem. So now our first aim is 0.77 volumetric efficiency. You have already calculated, huh? Okay, good. So let me calculate the volumetric efficiency first. So volumetric efficiency equal to, I will use this formula because this compression ratio was given in the question and pressure ratio was also given in the question. So 1 plus C minus C P2 by P1 whole to the power 1 by N. So that implies volumetric efficiency equal to 1 plus, what is C value? C value is, we have calculated C value 0.05. Because it is written clearance volume is 5% of the swept volume. So 0.05 minus, this C is also 0.05 whole into P2 by P1 is 9 to the power 1 by N value is 1. So if we solve this, I got two answers, 344, 0.77, 305, 0.778. Right. So volumetric efficiency, we will take 0.77. Up to 3 decimal you take, so that exact answer you will get. 344, you are also correct. But if up to 0.3 decimals you are taking the value, then exact answer you can get. So always try to take up to 3 decimal points, right? So we got volumetric efficiency, this value we have calculated. Now we will calculate the actual volume of air entered. So we will calculate VA, that is the actual volume of air during suction. So that is nothing but our VA. Why I am calculating this one? Because this is the formula. I have already calculated volumetric efficiency. Now if I can calculate this VA value, then from this formula, swept volume directly I will get. So that's why I am calculating this VA value. Okay, what is VA? That is the actual volume of air during the suction. Means in the compressor, when the inlet valve will open, how much volume of air is entering? That is nothing but VA. So how to calculate this VA? We know air is nothing but an ideal gas. Air is nothing but an ideal gas. Okay. So for ideal gas, we have a ideal gas equation. Okay. What is ideal gas equation? PV equal to MRT. This is the ideal gas equation. What is P? This is the inlet pressure of the air. What is V? This is the inlet volume of the air. What is M? This is the inlet mass of the air. R is universal gas constant. And T is the inlet temperature of the air. Okay. So from this formula, I can calculate the volume of air. So that implies, what is pressure of the air? Initial pressure. Initial pressure P1 was 101.3 kilopascal. So P1 value I will write 101.3 into inlet volume of air. V1 also you can write. VA also I can write. Both are same. Which is equal to, what is mass flow rate of air? Mass flow rate of air is 0.075. So mass flow rate of air I will write 0.075 into, what is this R? R is universal gas constant. So value of R is 0.287 kilojoules per kg. But here we have to convert, put this value in joules. No. Because this pressure we have taken in kilopascal. 101.3 pressure we have taken in kilopascal. So everything we will keep in kilo. This R value also we will put 0.287. Everything should be in kilo. This pressure is in kilopascal. So this R value should also be in kilo, kilojoules. Okay. Into, what is T1? T1 is 288. So it's 288. Now you solve this equation and tell me from here how much VA value we are getting. We are getting 0.0611. Yes, 313. 0.0611. Can you tell me the unit? What is the unit of this one? What is the unit? Is it kg or is it meter or is it meter square? Or in meter cube, what is the unit of this one? 313, exactly. 344, it is not meter cube. 305, no, it is not meter cube. It is meter cube per second. 313, Sudhir is correct. Actually, what is the unit of volume? Unit of volume is meter cube, we know. We know that unit of volume is meter cube. But you see the unit of this mass. Is it in kg or kg per second? This mass value is in kg per second. Everything we are calculating per second. Okay, so that's why the unit is meter cube per second. If the unit of this mass is in kg, then this unit will be in meter cube. But the unit of this mass is in kg per second, as it is given in the question, mass flow rate. So that's why the volume is meter cube per second. Okay, I think you have you got it. 344 and 305. Okay, it is not meter cube. It will be meter cube per second because the unit of mass is given in kg per second. Okay, so volume unit we got in meter cube per second. Okay, so already we have got the volumetric efficiency from here and the volume of air we got from here. Okay, so now we can calculate the swept volume. Swept volume. Calculate here. Swept volume. That is VS. So volumetric efficiency, this formula I am using, is equal to actual volume of air divided by swept volume. That implies, what is the actual volume? Sorry, what is the volumetric efficiency? 0.778. is 0.778 is equal to actual volume we got 0.0611 whole divided by swept volume. So from this equation, this VA take to left hand side, this one you take to right hand side, solve this equation, and swept volume you will get is 0.344 Prasant. Once you check your answer, whether it is 0.78 or 0.078. Yes, 0.0785. Right. So you get it 0.0785 meter cube per second. So this is the swept volume of the cylinder we have calculated. Right, 344. So in this way, we can calculate the swept volume of the cylinder, right? So that's the answer for the second part of the question. Okay. I mean, this part also we have completed. Cylinder swept volume, right? Very simple it is. So you read the question, draw the PV diagram. If it is a two-stage compressor, it will be good for you to write the formula, draw a PV diagram, write down the given data, okay, note it down what you have to calculate, then give the point number one, indicated power, write down the formula, put the value, you will get the answer. Then point two, okay, write down what you have to calculate, give the heading, then a little bit analyze how to get a swept volume. You write down in the rough, you write down all the formula of swept volume. Swept volume is meter cube, I guess. Okay, I will tell that.
Seven.
Yes. I will come to that. Your doubt is swept volume is in meter cube. But here we have got in meter cube per second. How to convert this meter cube per second into meter cube, I will tell you. So here, swept volume formula, one formula is pi by 4 d square L into n by 60. But in this question, diameter was not given. Length was also not given. So this formula directly we cannot use to calculate swept volume. But we have one more formula in terms of volumetric efficiency. Volumetric efficiency is actual volume by swept volume, which is equal to 1 plus C minus C, P2 by P1 to the power 1 by N. But here the question is, this volumetric efficiency is not given, but this clearance ratio and pressure ratio is given. So first we will calculate volumetric efficiency by applying this formula. Put the value, we will get the volumetric efficiency. Next, we will calculate the actual volume of air. Okay. So we will calculate the actual volume. How to calculate the actual volume of air? By, since air is an ideal gas, so for ideal gas, we can write PV equal to MRP. The inlet temperature or pressure, inlet volume, inlet mass, inlet temperature value, everything is given. Put it here, we will get the volume of air entered. Okay. Now, once we got VA, once we got efficient volumetric efficiency, then apply this formula, and from this formula, we will get the stroke volume or swept volume. But here, the swept volume, this is not the swept volume. This is called rate of flow of swept volume. Because the swept volume we got in meter cube per second. Okay. But if you will see the cylinder swept volume, the unit of cylinder swept volume is meter cube. Okay. But we got in meter cube per second. If you will do or put this in the exam, if it is a 5 marks question, okay. Then if you will give the answer from the, either the examiner will give you full 5 marks he will give, or 4.5 he will give. Okay. Some examiners, if they are very good, so 5 marks, full 5 marks they will give you. If they are strict, then 4.5 they will give. And if they are very, very strict, then at least 4 marks they will give. Okay, but if you want the exact answer, what we have to do? We have to convert this meter cube per second into meter cube. How to convert it? In the given data, you can see the speed of the engine is given. And we have not used this n value so far. It is revolution per minute. Okay. So can you tell me how to convert this meter cube per second into meter cube? How to convert this volume flow rate into volume? Can you guess? Vs into n. Okay, Prasad, Vs swept volume into speed of the engine. If we will do that, what is the problem we will get, I will tell you. Okay. Because if I will directly tell you the formula, you may get confused. You will forget it. Okay. So according to Prasad, I think I have written the spelling wrong. This H is not there. Okay, but okay, so what you are telling Vs into n we will do. If we will do in this manner, so what is our n? We should get the volume in meter cube. So what happens here? What is the unit of Vs? Vs unit we have got meter cube per second. So we will write it meter cube per second into, what is the unit of n? Unit is n is revolution per minute. N is nothing but RPM, revolution per minute. Revolution per minute or revolution per second, something like that we will get. Now, if we multiply these two things, what we will get? Meter cube per second into second is second square. Like this, some unit we will get. If we multiply n,
divide by one.
Yes, we cannot multiply it. Instead of multiplying n, we have to divide the n. Because when we are dividing n, Vs by n, if we will do, the unit of Vs is meter cube per second, and unit of n is, it is revolution per minute or revolution per second. Okay, so the second and second will cancel, so there the complete unit we will get in meter. Right? Okay, so like this. So here the swept volume. Get in Vs divided by n. So Vs is how much? Vs is 0.0785. Vs is 0.0785 divided by what is n? N is 300 RPM. It is revolution per minute. So again, this minute we have to convert into second. So what we have to do, we have to write here 300 divided by 60. Okay. So like this, you solve it and tell me how much answer we are getting. Why this 660 I have done? In order to convert minute into second. Because n value was 300 RPM. And if you want to convert this into second, it will be 300 by 60. 1 minute is 60 seconds. It will be this much RPS. Okay, so that's why in place of n, I have written 300 by 60. So now if we will solve it, we will get 0.0157. 0.0157. Equal to 0.0157. So this is the complete answer for this question. Yeah. So like this, no need to remember this formula. Okay. Just by analyzing the units, okay, we can write this one. So in this way, we can complete the 2019 question. Okay. So here we have got the answer for question number 7B. This question we have completed. Here, so this question was for 5 marks. This derivation was for 5 marks. This question was for 5 marks. Okay. So for indicated power, they will give you 2 marks, and for cylinder swept volume, there will be 3. So total 5 marks was there for this question. Yeah, right. So here what happens, whatever the problem related to this two stage compressor we have done yesterday and today, this word they have mentioned, intercooling is perfect. If it is a perfect intercooling, then directly we can write down this formula. But sometimes what happens in the exam, they will mention that the intercooling is not a perfect one. If intercooling is not perfect, then this P2 by P1 cannot be equal to P4 by P2 and T1 cannot be equal to T3. So in that case, separately work done we have to calculate for first stage, and separately work done we have to calculate for second stage. And then we have to add W1 plus W2 and we will get the total work. Okay. So next class, related to this imperfect cooling, one more problem we will do. Okay, and we will complete this unit. Are you getting my point? What I want to tell? Because whatever the problems we have done till today, means last class we have done one problem, today we did one problem. So in this problem, they have mentioned intercooling is perfect. If intercooling is perfect, then these two conditions will be satisfied and directly work done formula will multiply 2 and we will get the answer. Because what happens if intercooling is perfect, whatever the work done we will get in first stage, exactly same work done we will get in second stage also. So that's why we have multiplied 2. But if the intercooling is not perfect, then separately we have to find out the work done for the first stage of compression. Separately, we have to find out the work done for second stage of compression. Then we have to add W1 and W2 and we will get the final answer. Okay. Normally, they didn't ask any problems from imperfect intercooling, but we will prepare one question from that also. Even if they will ask this question, we should be ready to answer everything. So last, quickly I will show you the syllabus, then we will complete today's class. So this is the syllabus we have. So here, this part, staged compression means either it will be two stage. Staged compression means either it will be two stage or it will be three stage. Maximum 3 stage will be there. But in the question, in exam, mostly they will ask 2-stage compressor. 3-stage compressor, they are not asking. But if you want one more problem related to this 3-stage compressor, we can do. But it will be exactly same. For 2-stage compressor, in the formula, you are multiplying 2. For 3-stage compressor, you have to multiply 3. For 4-stage compressor, you have to multiply 4. Like that, you have to do. Nothing new is there. But in exam, mostly they will ask maximum 2-stage compressor. Okay. Next, undercooling or intercooling we have done. Saving of work. Yesterday, one more problem we have done where we have seen by in multi-stage compressor, we can be able to save work as compared to single-stage compressor. Okay. And minimum work condition for stage compressor. So this minimum work condition means one condition is T1 equal to T3. Second condition is pressure ratio P2 by P1 equal to P4 by P2. Okay, so these are the two conditions for stage compression. Okay, so along with this, entire third unit we have completed. This small part was left behind, fan blower and compressor. Okay. So some 3 marks question they are asking regarding this. What is the difference between, only theory part, what is the difference between fan, blower and compressor? Regarding compressor, already you know. You know what is a fan and what is a blower. That hair dryer is there. Okay, so that is a blower. So next class, one small theoretical difference between fan, blower and compressor. I will discuss. And one problem related to imperfect intercooling, we will discuss in the next class. I mean in the Monday, and we will complete the third unit. Okay. So in that manner, what we will do, we have completed, okay, this first unit we have completed already. We have completed this one. We have completed second unit. Okay. And third unit, it is almost completed. And we have completed fifth unit also. Gas turbine also we have completed. So the only thing which is left behind is unit 4. Okay. In unit 4 also, it is related to compressor only. Here, various types of compressors are there. Rotary compressor is there, dynamic compressor is there, and axial flow compressor is there. I think in fluid mechanics, you have studied regarding velocity triangles. Have you studied it? Somebody please respond. Or velocity diagrams. Have you studied this point in fluid mechanics? I think this semester you are having fluid mechanics. Regarding this velocity triangles or velocity diagram for turbine or for compressor, have you studied? Guru Shankar sir already, I think already he had told. Yes. Okay. So exactly same thing we are going to discuss over here in this unit. Okay. So whatever sir has discussed, okay, whatever the velocity triangles for nozzles, for impellers you have plotted over there, almost similar type of diagrams you have to do again here in compressor. You can see here velocity diagrams. Okay, velocity triangles. Okay, here velocity and pressure variation. Almost same things are there in unit 4. Okay, so that's why I have kept this unit 4 at the last. So that in fluid mechanics, already you will study regarding velocity triangle, and hence it will be easy for you and it will be easy for me to explain unit 4. That's why I have skipped unit 4 and I have completed unit 5 at that time. So now you have some idea regarding velocity triangle, how to draw the velocity triangles for the turbine blades. Okay. So if you have those, that little bit ideas you have, so it will be easy for me, or it will be easy for you to understand unit 4. Okay, so that's why I have kept this unit to be covered at the end of the syllabus. Right. So next week we are going to start unit 4. On Monday, we will solve one problem related to imperfect undercooling and we'll complete unit 3, and then we'll start unit 4 from Tuesday onwards. Yeah. So that's all about today's class. Once again, we will meet on Monday. Okay. So these notes, yesterday I failed to share the notes. Today I will, yesterday class notes and today's class notes I will put in the group. Once you go through it, practice the problems, whatever we have done yesterday and today. If you are getting any doubt, feel free to ask. So have a nice day. Bye.